distracted by an item that could cause you to fall behind in your credits. We want you to graduate on time, and we want you to be successful. And it means that you then have to understand when it's the time for business and when it's the time for pleasure. ASA, Black Student Union, the Debate Club, we have a math club, yearbook club, and we also have the Associated Student Body. And I want to have Coach Bianca come forward. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Juana. Where's Mr. Juana? I want to have Mr. Juana come forward to talk about attendance.
You won't like me once you get to the party.
Don't do that.
Love her.
All right. So, how many of you planning on being the school?
Boom!
That's right. How many of you plan to get to school on time?
I plan to get them to school.
So my expectation is that you are at school on time each and every day, Monday through Friday, right? Not unless we have a holiday or if it's PD and you need to leave early, right? If you are late, there is no grace period. School starts at 8:30. What time should you be at school?
8:30.
Should you be at school 8:31?
8 o'clock.
Be at school at 8 o'clock, Ms. Perry. 8 o'clock. Be here at 8:30. If you are late, please come to the front office and I will print you out a late pass. You then need to take it to your teacher and it is unexcused.
Oh boy.
If you have an excused absence. So what's an excused absence or tardy?
Doctor's
appointment, dental appointment, if you had to, like some other type of emergency or something like that, then you will bring in a note to me, that's an excuse. If you do not bring that, that's an unexcused absence or tardy, okay?
Mm-hmm.
How that will affect you. Every Friday, we will have off-campus lunch for those that have perfect attendance. So please don't come to me and say, Mr. Juana, I promise you I was here every day. And then I go in and I look, and you were tardy to third period. If I see it, do you have perfect attendance?
Negative.
No. You will miss out on off-campus lunch that Friday. So we will look at the week prior. If you have perfect attendance the week prior, you then will have off-campus lunch. Parents, you will receive a permission slip that will state that you allow your students to leave off campus to go and get lunch. That means, students, that you also will behave, you will use your manners, you will make sure you remember you represent Emory High School, you make sure you remember you represent your parents, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when you go out to get your food, make sure you're always being respectful and using your manners. If you are late coming back from off-campus lunch, you will lose it. If you act out while you're out there, you will lose it. So make sure you are on top of your manners and being respectful, right?
Yeah.
The three P's, even when you are outside eating off-campus lunch. And then make sure you bring me something back.
Your manners.
All right. Also, one more thing, Ms. Smith. When this is done, how many of you have finished your online registration? If you are re-enrolling or need to enroll, how many of you have finished? Raise your hands high. If you finished your re-registration.
I still have more.
If you have not, Will and George, our IT specialists, are in the back, and they will help you finish with your re-enrolling. Okay?
Okay.
So when we're done here, please go over to this room in the back and finish your enrollment. Thank you.
Thank you.
Kathy Ann will take questions.
No.
Kathy Ann will build a PowerPoint. We'll take questions.
He gonna forget.
Oh.
Now to the sports team. We have softball, volleyball for girls and boys.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Hi.
I said good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
That sounds a little bit better.
So my name is Coach
Bianca. Most of the kids call me Coach B, and I am half of the athletic department.
Myself
and Coach Todd, we are the athletic directors here at Emory High School. So I just want to wrap around to let you parents know exactly what my role here at Emory. So I am the bad cop of the bunch. So if your student is having an issue academically, you will hear from me. Or if we're having an issue financially, and what I mean by, I'll talk about finances first. If for some reason your student has refused to turn in their uniform, you will hear from me. So, as Principal Smith mentioned, we have a variety of sports teams, and I hope that your students decide to come out and sign up for one of our sports teams. Today, your student will be able to list if they would like to play a sport or sign up for one of our clubs. The table is here in the back, where some of the parents are sitting right now. But Coach Greg, right now, raise your hand. Our sports table is back there. Hopefully they will sign up for one of our various sports. Just to let you know, our girls volleyball team has already started, and we actually have our game the day before school starts. Grade point average to stay on our sports team. But not only that, behavior in the class. So say for instance, if your student is acting up in class that day, but they think that they're going to go out for their game. No. I do not care what their coach says because, to be honest, I am their coach's supervisor. So I will pull your student from the game for that day. Your student can be mad and you can be mad as well. But we hold a standard here at Emory.
Say upset.
And you are called a student athlete. Student comes first. So you need to show respect in the classroom and also on campus in order for you to get out on the court and also on the field for track to be able to play. So we demand respect for our staff and our teachers at all times. Also, your grades have to be up to par. So for our sophomore students, if you had a grade point average that is not, we, as Principal Smith said, we have mandatory study hall. Everyone this year will have mandatory study hall from 3:30 to 4:30 every day, every sports team. And every sports team will be assigned a study hall room. Therefore, I will be able to walk around and make sure that every team is having study hall where they're supposed to be. I know that there are teachers like Ms. Critchlow, who teaches Spanish. She has tutoring every day except for Fridays. So there is no reason why your student should be failing Spanish, because she is here every day, 4 days a week, to give your student tutoring. And she is available, and I have a lot of our students, our teachers are, including Mr. Burns. He is here even on Friday, and he is our computer teacher, to give your student tutoring. There's a lot of our teachers who are here on a daily basis after school. So you guys, your students are able to get tutoring every day. There's no reason for your student to come home and say, I didn't have time to do my homework, because that is false.
I don't like that Spanish being a required subject.
Every day from 3:30 to 4:30.
I should say something about that.
This is for our freshmen through 12th grade. Secondly, I would like to talk a little bit about our booster club. I'm also the booster club president. And I need help, because for the past 4 years, I have been running it by myself. So if I have any parent volunteers that would like to assist me, I do have a sign-up sheet today, and I will be able to tell you a little bit more about the Booster Club, and you can meet me in the back at the table after orientation. So the Booster Club supports all of the sport teams and the clubs here on campus. Say, for instance, when they need money for different supplies, that is where the money comes from. runs the concession stand, the booster team runs the games. So when you pay for your entrance fee to the gymnasium and also to the field when the kids have games, that is where the money goes into. So all of the money that goes into the funding of the booster club goes right back into the students. So a lot of times I have parents saying, well, why do I have to pay, or I have even the students? Because the students do get charged to come watch their peers play, but it's only a $2 charge. And a lot of times I tell the students, you go down to Papa Murphy's, you go to the store, and everything of that nature, and you patronize.
We still struggling. We ain't got nothing to put back into
it. But I sell a lot of the same things that they buy at the store. So all the money goes right back into the students. But they constantly say, Coach B, we need this. Coach B, we need that. Where do they think that money comes from?
The government.
So if we can sow into others, sow into yourself.
The government.
So I'm open
to pay all that kind of stuff. Period.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The government is supposed to cover a lot of that, period.
Next, if we could have Ms. Dunn come up and speak about our health center that we have on campus.
A lot of school supports, school finance support.
I'm sorry, Ms. Dunn and Ms. Candy King.
And
we can pop it up for these two
ladies.
And Mr.
Rebecca.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
The reason it looks like I need my health center because I hyperextended both of my Achilles tendons walking around New York. I mean, I was cute, but my little and unfortunately, I was like, by the end of it, but we're getting better. I represent wellness, which is a big department. It includes medical, it includes counseling, it includes the food service department, it includes the after-school program for the grammar school. And I look forward to seeing if we can do something for the high school. What I wanted to do today was to introduce you to two ladies who are part of the school-based health center. It is a free clinic for your students. Repeat that again, a free clinic for your students. It's throughout Alameda County and through the state of California. Now what does that mean to you?
Government.
I'm going to have them tell you a couple of stories and let you know the services they provide.
Funded by
it
the government is what it says.
You're at work, you're at home, your student gets a blood meal or
government.
Falls down or runs into a hole, which has all happened actually.
Tensions.
And they can take it to the school-based health center and we can help them out, make sure they're okay. We can prescribe, because of the school-based health center, they can give us an aspirin. Even though we have a school nurse, no aspirin. Okay, pain medication, Tylenol. Even though we have a school nurse, she cannot, repeat, cannot prescribe anything to your student or help to take care of them until you can get there or until they can be transported to the hospital if that is necessary. We have an application in the back that we'd like you to fill out. It does not replace your primary physician, but you only have to fill it out once. And then from kindergarten to 12th grade, they can avail themselves of the services up there. A couple of things I want to say, and then I'll let you talk to Ms. King and Ms. Rebecca. If you are bringing medication onto the campus, if that means you have diabetes medication that you have to take, it has to be filled out. I have some in the back here also. So basically we're trying to bring you all around services for your students so that they can do what we can't do. They can come here and be whole and we can make sure that they get taken care of.
School's been at a fake nursing center.
My name is Angie Kane. I'm the site supervisor here at the health center. What Ms. Juliet touched on a little bit is we do provide services for all the students, but we can't provide those services if you do not fill out what we have as a consent form. If that consent form is not filled out, the most we can do is care does not replace your primary care providers. So it's just basically while your child kid is here at school. If there's a service we don't provide, we will send out a referral to your primary care doctor, and that way your primary care doctor can take care of those services. We offer sports physicals. So, but we can't do the sports physical if we don't have that consent form filled out.
After your
stay in school or go home. So I really try to coordinate the parent, what works best for you guys and for the kid. I try to be very communicative with the parent as well.
There will be no bill sent home to the parents. There's no co-pays. It doesn't matter what your clinics that we're going to be setting up so that we can get flu shots to people.
No way.
For adults as well as children, so we'll send out information on that.
Nah.
You can check that off the list. Attend our sports events, as Coach Bianchi said, attend to support the students coming back to school night. Join our school site council. Attend coffee with the principal. That will be the first Friday of each month where you come and you can sit down and meet with me. There'll be coffee and donuts and we can talk about things that are coming up, concerns or questions that you may have, or any other information that we have that's coming up that I want to share with you guys. We also have to join the Booster Club, but we also have PTO as well, two parent organizations. We have our ELAC, and then finally, we also have Open House. So please, please, please get involved. It makes a big difference. We also have a program that we're going to be introducing this year, which is the Alameda County Student Transfer Pass Program. I've met with one of the directors, and we have forms that if you complete, and they'll also be on the back table, your student can get a free bus pass. And so you have to complete it. I need to get as many people as possible. Hopefully everybody takes advantage of this free program. I can turn it in, and all students, you can use them at any time. For field trips, you can use them going and coming, going to school on the weekends, whenever. But it's a free pass for the students to use. So please take advantage of this program. Because if we don't get a lot of responses to it, we won't be able to benefit from it, and they'll go to another school or another place to use it. And I fought to get this to come here. Jessica and I actually worked together to get this to come for our middle school students and for the high school. And so, again, there are sign-ups at the back tables, starting here in the back, going around to this side of the room for all the clubs that I mentioned. Not all the clubs, some of the clubs that I mentioned, the Boosters Health Center, and there are parents with the AC Student Pass Program. And so, at this time, if there are any questions, I think there was a question over here. Can we have you guys hold it down in the back for a second, because this question may be something that other people want to know.
Your student was marked tardy or absent. And what I would ask is that the program that was rolled out
some
last year
be
at
cutters.
In the high school, they're still working out the bugs, and that was something that we requested that we drill down to here so you would have more specimens. Thank you. Yes.
You know I got some questions. No, I'm about to stand at the podium question.
Let me ask you. No, it's for all families.
I want to be able to release people to go start signing up. But go
okay,
ahead.
I have three questions.
Yeah.
You was talking about the bus passes. Is that will that be by monthly for each month or for a whole quarter or year, or how would that bus pass go?
As far as I know, once they issue it to them, uh-huh. they will have it for the whole year.
Okay.
If there is any renewal, it probably won't be until the start of next year. But as I get that information, I can roll it out. I'll let everyone know.
And when will they get their student IDs?
Oh, good question. After we take pictures.
Okay.
Usually we take the pictures when they come out.
Okay. Other question. I think Mr. Wong might be on this one too. Are we still doing this year call to make an appointment to come to the school to check on your child? Because me, myself, and I'm old school. I do pop-up. I like to pop-up.
But amen.
You guys have all these rules and regulations with our child, that our rule is we got to make an appointment to come see our child.
So is that true?
So are you referring to meeting with the teacher?
No, just come to check on it.
Because me, myself, I always tell all my kids, call me, text me anytime, right at that moment, that child acting up. You probably back there clowning and laughing while I'm talking about it. But
Willie's
my thing is, will we still have to make appointments? I want to walk in. I don't want no teacher to call me and say, your child is your child. I want to catch him doing that. I want to catch him. You know what I'm saying? So that's. And then I want to ask about the PTC. PTO. Okay.
All right, so we'll answer this question, and then I'll release you, and I can talk more online about offline about
this. Okay, so I'm gonna say this. My daughter just graduated from here in 2018. I had to make an appointment, and I was just like, what? What you mean? But in order for us to keep consistency and the respect of the teacher in their classroom, yes, if you want to go to the classroom, you will need to make an appointment. Let the teacher know you want to come in on a certain day so they will know and have that heads up.
See, I don't want that because I don't want the teacher to say, oh, your mama coming in. I want to walk in there.
So that's the conversation you have with the teacher. And say, hey, don't tell your mama come.
How many days in advance do they?
24. Okay, yes. Will we have Illuminate or something like that?
Yes, you will. All parents should have access to Illuminate to be able to check grades and keep abreast of the assignments and everything. When you enroll your student, your passive connection is done with Illuminate, and it's just reminding you. Dr. Scott, if you could come forward, please.
Hey,
thank you so much. I will keep it brief, but I'm just so excited to see so many people here today supporting their young ones. We know that parent involvement is key to student success, and so I've listened to your input, for instance, with the attendance. I've already reached out to our IT department to make sure that we can get that information out to our parents that is sent to you correctly. So your input is appreciated. We're so glad to have you here, and we wish our students, your children, or our children, we wish them a very successful year. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming. Please feel free.